And we're back. Random villager. Looking for pieces of horn. I don't know if we can just ask anybody. It has to be a named NPC. I don't know. The Trader Fira must have hit the same weather as you coming to town. Alright, there's a... She wants to help us to use this metal or ore detector on Durgan's battery, which we haven't been to yet. So, we're not done with her quest. Leave her alone. Theorish we already dealt with. We completely dealt with the Temple of Andra last episode. So we wrapped up that quest and wrapped up that and killed everybody. Let's head to the Graves of Rest. Let's head to this. There's some people standing outside. And then we'll head in. We gotta cure this guy of his... What happened to him again?
You have to help me. Ugh, I can't stay like this.
Reyfald sniffs. I think I have what we need. I just need to give these ingredients to Halfrack.
Oh, thank the gods. I'll wait here and hope nobody comes by to talk.
I forget what exactly happened at... Wait. Yeah, Alof is inside. We can tell him about that we killed the slave hunter. He's lost all feeling in his face. Haha. Awesome. You're a nice change from the usual madcaps and mercenaries. Thanks. Durgan's battery is haunted. That's why merchant caravans avoid it. Teildor. Oh, right. He wants that thermal pearl. Nope, I haven't been there yet, guy. Alright, let's go inside. This is the Grave's Rest. Just get two quests we can wrap up in here. Reyfald can wait. Let's go help, what's his name? Orland Fellow, I believe he is. Alof.
Any progress with Dvala?
She's dead.
Oh, thank the gods. Every last one of them. I never thought I'd see this day.
Relief brightens his expression. One second.
And thank you most of all. Here, take this. And tell Halfrick that he can keep the rest of the week's fee. I'm off.
Yay. Excellent. What's in here? Fruit. Major adventure completed. Zawa returns to the stronghold with average reputation with Deerford Village. Alright, cool. And money. Spoils await, etc., etc. Hardly anyone coming up the rows these days. You're the first new face in weeks. Yeah. Talk to these people already. Anyone here? Owenna?
Something I can do for you? Halfrick's got me straightening the rooms.
He sure does. Who we can ask about this horn? Wish you'd been around when old Mayor Sinewad was cleaning our coffers. Good thing Halfrick still has some venison in stock. Hardly any elk left.
Got rid of that little fella, eh? Take this with my thanks. Didn't need his trouble around here. Anyway, what brings you back?
Oh, yeah. I found the ingredients you asked for. For some reason, that didn't register with me.
Still say a little hardship ought to put some sense into that man. But if you're set on giving him a hand, so be it. Give that here.
Giving it here.
There. Get him to down that, and he'll be right as rain. And you can tell him he owes you one. I would have let him stew for at least a year or so.
Ugh. I wish I hadn't seen that. Hafrick was true to his word and gave me a mixture for Reyfald to drink, which should clear his little problem. Alright, let's ask about this horn in here before we go anywhere. Let's ask the cook, I guess. I don't know. Funny what a raid does for the appetite. Alright, never mind. I heard the dwarves of Durgan Battery died feasting. Poison one another. Katie?
Hello, ma'am. Anything I can do for you?
Apparently not. I don't want to pay any more racist arts. You and your racist arts. See if you get that reference. Never had a much of a knack for knife throwing myself. I can't stand here watching you playing your racist darts. Alright. Done with that.
You find anything? Hate to think of those slimy bastards carrying my haul into a freezing hole somewhere.
Not yet. We'll have to ask around here. It was only a little trouble. Don't see many Valians since Galvino left town. You and your racist darts. If you have voices around the battery, yeah, I've seen that. I want to talk to her. Oh, I don't remember these other two kids. Bet you can't hop over the coals. No, I'm not taking that bet. Are the giants going to eat us? Absolutely. Alright, let's get out of here. These people are not helpful. Hey. Frozen lips.
You have to help me. Ugh. I can't stay like this.
Get a hold of yourself. Here, Hafrick says this ought to do it.
Lily? Oh, Anta bless you. Give it here, please.
Sorry, it's you, it is.
Ugh, frothy. Hey, you did it! I can feel again!
He prods at his forehead and sticks out his tongue.
Oh, thank you. You're a saint among kith, and I owe you one, I know it. I would have ended up a leper. Averick never did have any sense of proportion. Hey, here, now that my hands are working again, I've been stitching this together for a while. Least I can give you, really.
So we've got something called a pilferer's grip.
And now I'm going to stand here and breathe for a little while.
I got the cure from Hafrick, and Reyfald is back to normal, for better or worse. He was very relieved and gave me a set of gloves he'd crafted as a reward. Okay, they're gloves. Taxes. Yeah. Another major adventure? Let's put Horavius this time.
Hey there. Let me know if you need anything.
I have some questions. I like this though.
Sure, ask away. Not sure what I can tell you though. I haven't been here half as long as most.
Who are you again?
Me? Well, I used to build houses. These days I do this and that. Get work at the fishery sometimes, mending nets. Right now I'm helping with the stockades. The ogres keep us busy.
Yeah, my apology, guys, if you said this before and you've seen it, I don't remember.
I'm from Ina's Rest, originally. Not so far from your Cadnua, actually. Hmm. A little ways east. Nice lake nearby. A little like the one here.
Now that, this is new to me.
I heard some business went down with Lord Radrick.
Hmm.
Might have ended up tithing to you instead, if I were still there. M'lady.
Reyfald cracks a grin. What can you tell me about Stalwart?
Truth is, I couldn't care less about the town, or the mines. But I like the people. Hardy bunch, living up here in the cold. Shame most of them have packed up. Feels like everything's conspiring to chase us out of here sometimes. Just means the ones of us that are left are the most stubborn-headed, right? Or foolish?
I suppose. That's all the questions I had.
Right. Anything else, then?
I want to say that other thing.
Hey there. Let me know if you need anything.
I thought you were cured. You mean you always looked like that?
Yes, fine. Ha ha. I'm doing much better, actually, and everything seems to be working like it ought to, so thanks.
Alright, I'll be going.
Take care.
Meningeld's house? I don't know if he wrapped anything up with Renningeld. Fira, yeah, we just talked to her. Yeah, we're doing that after, probably the last thing. Thrist twin. Oh, that's... yeah, we're not doing that. We're at the other piece of the horn. Longwatch Falls. Thermopearl, Longwatch Falls. Bounty. Durgan's Battery. Or near it. Sacred Instruments, Durgan's Battery, or near it. I don't know what's going on with this. That might have to do with, the monk, Zawa. Oh, we can't talk to her. She wants to kill us now. Something secret? No, we're not giving him knives. Is that really it? Okay, we just have to find this piece of the horn then. Maybe, Renningeld knows us or her son.
Any luck with Durgan's Battery?
Nope, I haven't been there, but what can you tell me about Fira's expedition?
Who? Sorry, I don't recall the name.
Her brow furrows.
Last expedition I met disappeared weeks ago. Didn't give any names, but they definitely haven't come back this way. Don't mean this Fayara weren't part of an expedition, though.
Fayara.
We get groups passing by sometimes looking to try their luck. What's on your mind?
Absolutely nothing at this point.
You did right in parlaying with Barragan. Don't know that anyone else here is going to see it that way, but I thought you should know. About the only thing folk here haven't tried. Killing one more matron won't change things for long. Besides, her clan's flames that whisper. The one that attacked us was Wolf with many mouths. I'd know him anywhere.
They're cut from the same cloth, Aldrich.
Yeah.
Something else you need?
Seen that before. Can't tell her anything new about Barragan, then.
Any luck with Durgan's Battery?
Yeah. Alright. Who knows about this helm? Let's check in here, then. Somebody knows.
Got to speak up? My hearing ain't what it was.
Did you say something, dear?
Nope.
Got to speak up?
Uh-huh. You should have killed the matron when you had the chance. Ditto.
Feels like it's hardly worth putting the huts back up.
Better than standing out here shivering.
The traitor, Fiara, must have hit the same weather as you coming to town. That's pretty random, though. Nice to see you. The ogres will be back. They were just testing our strength. Maybe the harbor master or fishmonger fish master knows. Fisheries closed for the night. Oh, really? We have a day and night cycle for real with people? I mean, as far as... Huh. That's just interesting, though. Huh. Now we have to wait for this guy to come back. These guys are still going. This cold must be nothing to you. No, not really.
I hope you've had some luck. And do take care with that device. It has a few rather delicate components.
Nope, haven't been up there yet. At least you got me to hear one piece. Fiara lost her wagon and crew. And she must have hit the same weather. Who else can we talk to about this? Maybe we can ask the Edurin. Ah! Would you happen to possess an old helm? Or a horn that looks like it's supposed to be attached to a helm? Edurin opens a compartment in his wagon and pulls out a cracked horn partially wrapped in cloth. One of the villagers sold me this during a previous visit, he scowls. He said it came from some rare lake creature and was quite valuable. It's been dismissed as junk whenever I try to resell it. Unless you know otherwise? Nah, it's a lie. No, it's largely worthless. However, I know of a collector for that sort of thing, if the price is right. I'll sell it to you for the same price I bought it. 300 pans. Done. Ooh, yeah. The world fades and your vision blurs. When it returns, you find yourself in the icy waters of a bay, your body numb from the cold and your lungs burning from exertion. Nearby are Ardell and Badrin. Both of them are swimming madly in an effort to pass you. On the distant shore await the other members of your tribe, and with them, Alara, daughter of the chieftain. It is for her hand that the three of you are competing today. Give up, Garad. Ardell passes you, and despite your best efforts, you can't quite catch up. You look around to see where Badrin is, and it's by sheer chance that you caught sight of the sea serpent's head surging towards your group. As before, the world stops. The memories trail lost without your guidance. Let's make it exciting. Attack the serpent. We are determining what he's doing at this point, which is interesting. Your fatigue falls away as you turn to face the serpent. It charges you, its jaws wide, its foot-long teeth flashing in the sunlight. At the last moment, you dodge to the side as its jaws snap shut, your hair too slow, and one of the serpent's horns tears open your forearm to the bone. You grit your teeth against the sudden pain and wrap your arms around the serpent's neck before it can turn around. It thrashes and rolls wildly, trying to throw you off. You hang on for dear life, weaker with every breath as your blood drains. You do the only thing you can think of and jam your fist straight through the serpent's eye, burying your arm as far as it can go. The serpent whips around in agony and your grip slips. You tumble through the air as your consciousness fades. The race. How could I have forgotten the events of that day? Garrot looks at his hands. I remember it now, but I feel no different yet. Please, you must find the last part of my helm. I have recovered two parts of Garrot's chorus. Only one part still remains. Battery relief tile? Where'd I find this? This anvil-shaped tile feels cold in your hand. One side of it is pittered and weathered, but the other is perfectly smooth. It appears to be made of iron. Oh, these are the horn pieces. This horn was once mounted on a helm. A long crack runs down its length. Maybe we can't, like, do combine. We can actually pick up anything in this container. Still a bit early to close off, so we will go into look a little bit of Longwatch Falls. Not pause. Master.
Keeping an eye out.
Vicious war criminals arrive seeking employment. But your patrols... He was nearly set upon by brigands on the road, but your patrols intervened. What's the difference? He's a vicious war criminal. So let the brigands have him. Yeah, why not? Oh. I've reached Longwatch Falls. The hot springs Teodor mentioned should be nearby. Somewhere. Lower left of the map. Brentwyn Ban. Big Cliff. Oh. What the hell? This tower looks like it was carved from the stone of the cliff. The entrance is collapsed and sealed with ice, but you imagine that it commands an impressive view of the valley below. Oh, there's a bitter spirit or something. I'm sorry you're so bitter. A green stone staff and fine mail armor. I guess they didn't like that we took that. Oh, look at this. Oh, it's one of those soul-bound weapons I've heard about. Binds with wizard, druid, or monk. Well, then I'm gonna have to give it to, Durance. Plus 1.8 weapon reach. Exceptional, so it's plus 8 accuracy and plus 30% damage. It grants nature's mark on critical hit, which is foe AoE minus 10 deflection minus 10 reflex per encounter. Kill 5 animats with greenstone staff to unlock the next level. 5 animats. A twisted piece of wood grips a glowing Adra chunk with root-like tendrils. Something about the staff resonates in your soul. When you hold it, you hear the distant whisper of wind through the trees. Can I swap out Durance's staff? I'm not sure I could do that. An Edirin explorer in Ir Glanfath came across a row of Adra pillars near what is now Salas Vale. Having never seen such a display of living Adra, he thought immediately of the Einskithra that houses the souls of Edirin nobility, and decided that these pillars must surely hold something magnificent. He chiseled a chunk of Adra from the growth and brought it back to Dunreed for further study. Alright. I'd like to give it to Durance. Let's give it to Durance. Okay. Now we fight things that see us anyway, so... Did we kill that already? I guess we did. Oh, a Shangri-La thingy. Attack. Oh, she's stuck. Oh my God, help him. Specters. Challenge anymore. What is a challenge is getting him to stop that. I have no idea how to do that. Just put up with it. Not enough.
Hello?
It's a soulbound weapon. Okay, let me check this out. Compare. Does it get better once you do Soulbind? Oh, it's definitely much better than Durance's staff. Now, I thought I couldn't switch out his staff. I can? Ooh, look at you! He'll always keep it, though. That's a special staff. I can't get rid of that. Oh, wizard druid or monk. Why did I think I saw... I thought I saw cleric. Never mind. Incorrect. Let's compare it to what he has, then. Better, yeah. Staff. Bind. Are you sure you want to soulbind greenstone staff to Aeloth? Once bound, this weapon cannot be used by any other character. Yes, because I don't use a druid or monk. Zawa's gonna join us briefly. We got sever binding also. What about the, it said something else. It's something about attacking animats. Now we deal 125 damage to beetles, or 625 damage to enemies, any enemies. Well, I guess at some point we'll get that. Alright. Yeah, we can't really go on this tower, or in this tower. I don't think we can. Ring grip areas. We explored a good deal of this map already. Alright, well, continue it next episode. Thanks for watching. See you then. Endure. And enduring, grow strong. Apparently there's a cave here. I don't know how we get there. Hold on a second. We have to go down there. I didn't see that. Okay. Interesting, though. All right, once again, endure. In enduring, grow strong.